Good morning, students. Today we will have our third class on the same topic, composition. Same question number, question one. So today we will discuss on argumentative composition. With this particular type, you all are already acquainted with because it was in your ICSE syllabus, and here also we find it in ISC. So, though you all know about argumentative composition, still it's required to revise those points again. So, you all know that argumentative composition is generally a debate topic, a debate in written form, right? So, here you are supposed to come to a conclusion through some logical discussion or through reasoning. And you need to express your opinion regarding any particular topic clearly, logically, coherently. And for that reason, you need to have a clear, coherent and logical thought, right? So, a definite point of view is required over here. That means if you are for the topic, then you have to be strictly for the topic. If you are against the topic, then you need to be strictly against the topic. So sometimes it requires a discussion, but you need to be very much clear that you need to remain biased for only one point of view, that is either for or against. Now again, you need to provide some examples to support your argument or to support your opinion, right? And genuine evidence with facts and figures, you need to bring forth your point of view. And you need to remember that sometimes concrete examples can make even vague philosophical ideas become clear and real, right? So you need to you need to keep all these things in your mind. Try to add a touch of humor in your argument. Yes, and you are not asked to involve yourself into any kind of controversy, right? And again, one thing you need to remember that you need to provide, you need to give due respect to everyone, to your opponent as well. Means at any point of time, debate should not sound like a quarrel, right? So you need to pay due respect to everyone, right? And sometimes you need to avoid the points which can be destructive criticism for yourself. So try to choose your points wisely, right? And sometimes it is found that the child starts with, means first you need to understand the topic very well. Then you need to understand whether you are for or against. Sometimes it is found that the student is saying, I support the statement, and whatever he or she presents as his or her points, that all those points go against that for. So you need to be very much cautious about this, and if it should not be like you have started with that I am for the statement, and at the end it is found you have written everything against the statement. So you need to be clear in this point also. Now these are the things you will get in your study material. Everything is jotted down over there. You need to go through them minutely and carefully, and there at a glance you will find the important things. That is, you have to plan your content around 5 to 6 main points, and you will start with the most striking one. Yes, and you will preserve the another most striking one at the end, so that when you end your composition, your logical, the most powerful points remain. It provides an impact on the reader, so it will help you to get marks, right? Then you need to develop each of those points, and you have to use examples to illustrate them, introduce humor if possible, and you should be very aware that that humor you are using, it shouldn't go against your points. It should be obviously, it should have a connection with your points. Then you can use statistics, facts or data, but you have to be very sure that those things are absolutely correct, right? Then it is very important to take a clear stance. That means either for or against, not both. Okay. And you should not start your sentences with and, but, because, and do not use short form, abbreviation, informal language, contractions, incorrect syntax and punctuations as well. And okay, then you have to divide your points into, like, you choose your points in such a way that definitely there will be the most appropriate one or two or three points will be definitely there. So try to put a very striking one at the very beginning, and when you complete your you are about to complete your composition, then at the end you try to put another one, and in between rest points you can include, right? So in this way you are supposed to compose your argumentative composition. The most important fact is you have to clearly choose only one stance, either for or against. You cannot be in between. If you are for the motion, you are nowhere to even consider anything against of it. Okay, so these are the main features. You all are already acquainted with all the features, all the characteristics of argumentative composition. So that's why I made this discussion. I hope it will prove helpful. And as your exams are there, so one by one I will be trying to make you understand the types of composition. So now you will find a worksheet along with this particular one, and you need to at least jot down your points, right? So when your exam gets over, I will be, whatever topics I'm giving, I will be definitely discussing on the points, right? So till we meet in our next class, you need to take very good care of yourself. Keep on doing your work. Keep on reading those subjects. The subjects are yet to take place. So till then, take very good care of yourself. Thank you. Have a nice day.